In my experience, one of the easiest ways to break down a poem, and in this case, a sonnet, is to actually show the students the different parts of it. It's almost like in a science class when you dissect an animal and you see the different parts within. That's exactly what we're going to do today with Shakespeare's Sonnet 18. We're just gonna look at each part, break it down, and talk a little bit about vocabulary words. So here we have Sonnet 18. As you can see, it's broken down into three quatrains and a couplet. Now, a quatrain is simply four lines. So as you see right here, you have the four lines here, you have four more lines here, you have four lines here, and then you end with what's called a couplet, because a couple is two, and you end in two lines. All right, next, you have your pentameter and your iambs. These are iambs, these are pentameters. So each iamb equals one pentameter, and that's where we get iambic pentameter. And how that sounds is a little bit differently than the way that we read poems today, but I'm going to show you how iambic pentameter in a sonnet sounds with line one. Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? It's almost like, it is a beat or a rhythm. Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? And you read the entire sonnet in that form. And that's the way that it was intended to be read by William Shakespeare during those times. Of course, now we don't typically speak like that. We don't read like that, but that's how it was intended during the time in which Shakespeare wrote it. Okay, next we have the rhyme scheme. And every sonnet by Shakespeare, Shakespearean sonnets, uses the same exact rhyme scheme. He does not deviate from it. And that rhyme scheme is A, B, A, B, C, D, C, D, E, F, E, F, G, G. Now, Ms. Ferguson, why did you use the different colors? I use the different colors to remind you guys that the same colored lines and the same letter lines always rhyme in a sonnet. Let's take a look. You have line A, day, may; B, temperate and date; C, shines, declines; D, dimmed, untrimmed; E, fade and shade; F, owest and growest; and then finally your cuppet, your GG lines, R, C, and D. Now, you have all of these components written in a one stanza poem. And that stanza means it's just one part to it. Some poems have three, four, five, however many that the writer wants to give. But in the case of the Shakespearean sonnet, you always have one stanza, three quatrains, one couplet, 14 lines, the A, B, A, B, C, D, C, D, E, F, G, G rhyme scheme. And lastly, it's written in your iambic pentameter. And there you have a sonnet in a nutshell.
Sonnet 18 by William Shakespeare. Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely and more temperate. Rough winds do shake the darling buds of May, and summer's length have all too short a date. Sometime too hot the eye of heaven shines, and often is his gold complexion dimmed, and every fair from fair sometimes declines by chance or nature's changing course untrimmed. But thy eternal summer shall not fade, nor lose possession of that fair thou owest, nor shall death brag thou wanderest in his shade, when in eternal lines to time thou growest. So long as men can breathe or eyes can see, so long lives this, and this gives life to thee.